This is Good Day Tampa Bay.
With Thanksgiving less than a week away, we've got a special cooking segment just for you. You've heard of empty calories, right? Food that fills you up doesn't really provide any nutrition. Well, this morning, we're going to tell you about naked calories and how they'll change the way you eat. With us today is Mira Kalton and Dr. Jason Kalton. Welcome.
Thank you.
This morning, they are going to show us how to make a rich Thanksgiving dinner. So what are naked calories? What does that mean?
Well, naked calories refers to food that has been stripped of its micronutrient value or its vitamins and minerals. So amazingly, over 90% of Americans are deficient in essential micronutrients. And this can be dangerous because over a prolonged period of time, this can cause chronic diseases like osteoporosis, hypertension, and even obesity.
And so your philosophy about eating rich foods and not poor ones, we're not talking about price here, of course, but what's the difference between rich food and poor foods?
Well, like we were talking about, rich foods are high in micronutrients, those vitamins and minerals that really enhance your health. Mm-hmm. So what we're telling people is we're not going to switch where you're eating.
Okay.
We're not telling you to ditch the Thanksgiving meal. We're telling you just to make sure that you infuse everything that you serve that day with extra vitamins and minerals.
Okay, so let's start with the turkey. Why not? What do we need to consider when we pick out the turkey?
Right. This is the star of Thanksgiving. So we want to get rid of the factory farm turkey this year. And we really want to focus on two words, organic and free range. All right. So organic is going to mean that it's not going to have any pesticides, GMOs, or hormones. And so that's going to That's one positive thing about buying an organic turkey, but the free range part of that is really where the micronutrient value comes in. So free range means that the turkey has had an opportunity to go outside, peck in the ground, get sunlight.
Okay.
And this is going to not only reduce the overall fat of the turkey by over 21%, but it's going to raise vitamin A by 50% and omega-3 fatty acids by 100%.
And we all want that,
yes.
Right? So the second most important thing for a lot of people is the stuffing. How do we make a stuffing that's full of nutrients, that isn't just bread? You say we should sprout our stuffing?
Right. So again, we're going to ditch the white bread and this year, and we're going to move to using a whole grain bread. But we're not going to stop at whole grain, because whole grain bread has something called phytic acid, which reduces the intake of over 9 different vitamins and minerals, including magnesium, calcium, and vitamin D. So we're going to go all the way over to a sprouted whole grain bread. And what that does is when they sprout it, they do it before they make the bread, and it reduces phytic acid content so you can absorb the nutrients that's in the bread, making it a rich food option for stuffing. Now, a lot of people say, where is the sprouted grain bread? It's not in the bread aisle. It's found in the freezer section of like a Whole Foods market.
That's great to hear, because people don't know this.
Yeah.
No.
They don't know this stuff. Now, what about the mashed potatoes?
Oh, they're fantastic. Everyone loves mashed potatoes, but we're going to make them rich. We're going to master the mashed potatoes this year by leaving the skins on. Most people don't
know. I like the skins, first of all.
Oh, good.
Yes. See,
and 50% of the vitamin C is actually in the skin.
Okay.
So we're going to leave them on, and then we're going to add an extra bonus. This is pasture or grass-fed butter, which means, as you can see, the color is much yellower.
Mm-hmm.
That's because there's 400% more beta carotene in butter from a grass-fed cow, which is incredible. It's amazing for your eyesight. We're going to do the same thing with our organic milks, majorly improving the amount of omega-3s. So we're really jam-packing with this with nutrients. And the kicker is the garlic. A little bit of garlic. And what it does is it has something called allicin, which is this incredible nutrient.
Who's that?
Yeah, exactly. Well, you're going to learn about it right now. What it does is it actually makes it so you don't get colds. It's been proven
Good
to reduce colds by 2/3.
And that's very simple.
Easy
fix.
That's very simple. Now, as I told you before we started, I will admit I've never had cranberry sauce that's not from a can.
Right.
And there are actual cranberries sitting here.
Well, we're leaving this with you then. What you want to do is you want to ditch the can. It has two ingredients which are always poor foods. Poor food ingredient number one, high fructose corn syrup. Bad. Number two, white refined sugar. So making it yourself is a fantastic way to reduce those poor foods. What we're going to sweeten it with is that kale stevia over there. It's a stevia leaf. It's from South America. It's great for diabetics because it doesn't spike insulin, and it doesn't have that sugar, so it doesn't block immunity, which a lot of people don't know. Sugar lowers your immune system.
Okay, and last but not least, dessert.
Pumpkin pie.
I mean,
Thanksgiving would not be Thanksgiving without pumpkin pie. And as you notice, we didn't get rid of anything. We still have the potatoes, we still have the turkey, the stuffing, and pumpkin pie is no different. We're just going to get rid of the white refined floured crust. And in all reality, pumpkin pie doesn't need a crust. It'll mold to the shape of the pan. And we're also going to get rid of that sugar that Mira talked about. We're going to use the stevia. And then for the whipped topping that goes on top of each piece of our pumpkin pie, we're going to use that grass-fed cream, and we're going to sweeten it with stevia again. So that's going to make for us a rich food version of pumpkin pie.
I love it.
Yeah.
I love it.
You can still
really
have it all.
You can still have a happy Thanksgiving where you leave the table stuffed and come back for more and more, right?
Right.
Absolutely.
But a healthy one this time.
Okay. Yep. Well, thank you, Mira Calton and Dr. Jason Calton. Thanks
thank
for being
for
with us this morning.
Thanks.